For our video project, we're discussing one of the biggest problems we have with our Maypole investigation.
We found it challenging to use the fundamental domain to figure out how many dancers and the color of the ribbons that they held throughout a Maypole dance.
The main problem we had with using the fundamental domain was that we could interpret the fundamental domain from the pattern that we were originally given up here in figure 7, but it was interpreting how that pattern would be with ribbons on a pole and how the fundamental domain would look on the pole.
It's easy, we can see here in this figure what the fundamental domain would be, seeing it as it is the smallest pattern that can be repeated, because there's like several like H's along here. So we use that as the starting point to figure out where the fundamental domain would be. And then since this is just like a black line, we incorporated that too because there's a black line in between all of the H's. So we started it with the black line and went over into the end of the H and then went to the top until we got to that dot, and we came up with a 4x4 fundamental domain that's repeated throughout the whole pattern.
It was really difficult for us, however, as we said, to determine exactly what this would look like on a maypole. So the next step that we took from there was to draw it out into a more realistic drawing. By doing that, we came up with something like this. This represents the maypole here, and then the ribbons coming off this way and this way. As you can see, the pattern shown is the same as what was given to us. You can still see the H's in the pattern and the solid black lines, but it's more realistic to what we would have seen on a maypole had we done the dance. The same fundamental domain can be found. We drew a 4x4 out right here with the domain, and we tried to use that to figure out the number of dance color of the ribbons.
Using this drawing and transferring figure 7 over onto a more realistic version of how it would look on the pole also helped in how we could trace the ribbons back to find the number of dancers.
Because the pattern that we were given, like this top right here, isn't necessarily the top of the maypole, it's just the excerpt where they cut it out. We kind of extended the ribbons this way and this way to kind of see where it would begin exactly, because we weren't given that information. So we extended the ribbons that would cross this way and the ribbons that would cross this way, and we found that there would be 4 black ribbons and 4 white ribbons that would make up this pattern.
This is easier maybe to understand. As you can see, the arrows we used to draw the orientation of the ribbons on the pole. The arrows represent which direction the ribbons were running throughout the dance, or the hypothetical dance. Understanding that for every ribbon that one runs one direction, there's a ribbon underneath it that runs the other, which is why we came up with 4 that come this way, but then their counterpart ribbons that come off the opposite direction. Following out the arrows, you can see that this black would have come off this way, so there would have been a black ribbon, a white ribbon, another black ribbon, a black ribbon, and in this direction, we would have a white ribbon, another black ribbon, and another white ribbon.